So some of you guys might be going, well, what the hell is that on the back of that tractor there? Well, some of you guys might remember when you watched me put in the front grass, and I didn't use the Scotts. I used the contractor brand. And then, of course, the weather came in, and it was bad. And it washed away, I don't know, 40% of my loam. And so because it's a hillside, I just didn't get to it. I got too many other projects, you know, like these here walking things. Yeah. And so last year, I was going to build one of these here Dethatchers. And when I found out that those little spring tangs down the bottom are anywhere between $3 to $5 a piece, and those are for the small ones, and I needed a goodly handful of them, I don't know, 20, 30 of them. By the time I got done building one, I might as well buy one. Well, in May, when I went looking for one, there wasn't one to be had anywhere. Lowe's didn't have them, Home Depot didn't have them, and it was going to take me 2 more weeks of delivery time, which was going to put me past where I wanted my step one down. So ended up at, I think it was at Home Depot, and they had one of these here Troy-built flex detached things. Yeah, which is what that is. And with a little bit of the cutting wheel on the bottom that removed the little foot stop that would go on that machine, I just clamped that thing right down to them bed frames that I got welded onto that old generator thing, which is my carry-all, brush picker-upper, beaver dam wrecker thing that I back into the beaver dam with that and pluck them out and take them with. But this here, I used this on the other side, and what I've learned since then is that to use the little groovies that this thing is going to make against the flow of water so that your seed doesn't run downhill. Yeah, at least as best as possible. So anywhere that there's a taper like going down into that, the water comes off the hillside, runs around the backside of the leach field here, and ends up going down the hill. And come winter time, that could have been 6 inches deep, but that ain't gonna happen anymore back there, because there was too much of a sloping, it didn't work. Well, now it's gonna work, because there's like 6 inches of rubble underneath the 4 6-inches of stuff right there. So yeah, it's gonna be beautiful. And the bird feeders are gonna have to wait. This here, I'm gonna use the Scotts water guard or whatever, the Scotts best seed. And yeah, it's expensive, but you know what? If you keep that stuff wet, it comes up in 9 to 12 days like a little chia pet. And so that's where we're at, and that's what we're doing. So yeah, I'll show you this thing and show you how she goes around a little bit here. And I got a 50-pound dumbbell down in there. Yeah, and when I use it to dethatch out on the hard stuff, I put 100 in there. And that way it digs in, and I can adjust it with the top link on the tractor there, this one. just quick like so as you could see the difference there. Yeah. I don't know if you could see that out here with the way the sun's coming over the tops here, but yeah, hopefully you can see how much more better of that is. The before and after. So